Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to look into how to provision your Python AI and machine learning kit from AWS. So for that, there are two ways you can do that. First is you can go to techlatest.net and at our homepage, click on products. And on the left hand side, you will see all the products listed down. You can click on Python AI and machine learning suite. And here, you can choose get it on AWS. So before we proceed, this video is covering how you can provision the VM on AWS, but the VM is also available on Azure and Google Cloud. And if AWS is not your cloud provider, and if you want to have it on Azure or GCP, Google Cloud, we have separate videos for that. So you can skip this video and follow the video for your respective cloud provider. Okay, so for the one who wants to have it on AWS cloud, you can click on get it on AWS. It will redirect you to our AWS marketplace. So this is one way you can navigate to the virtual machine. The other way is you can go to the marketplace first, like over here, and then in the search box you can type techlatest.net. It will give you all the VM listing from techlatest, and you can navigate to Python AI and machine learning kit. Click on that and then click on continue to subscribe and then follow the instruction. Okay, so here, you know, it will list you the product. You can click on continue to configuration. Now here, fulfillment option is through this AMI. You can select your region and continue to the launch. Now after the launch, you know, you can look into your, the usage instruction, or you can follow this video, which is the same. You know, whatever is covered in the usage instruction will be covered in this video as well. So you can launch it from the website, or you can launch it from the EC2 console. Okay, so let's follow the website launch from the website option. EC2 instance, by default, it will be T2 large, which comes with 8 GB RAM and two virtual CPUs. That should be enough for you to get started. So I suggest you go with those default. If you want a more beefy instance, you can always go and select that one. VPC setting, it will create a new VPC. If you want, you can select an existing VPC as well. Again, I suggest to create a new VPC, because there are some firewall rules which comes with this VM. Basically, we want to have port 80, port 22, and port 3389 open for this virtual machine. Port 80 is to access the IPython or Jupyter Hub environment. Port 22 is to access the VM through PuTTY. And then port 3389 is to access the virtual machine through a remote desktop. So let's go with the default VPC and subnets. It will create a new one. Then security groups, go with the default, or you can click on create new based on seller settings. So this is what I was talking about. So AI ML marketplace SG, you can give any name. Security group for AI ML VM provision from marketplace. You can see these three ports are open, and I will click on save. It will save that setting, and we'll click on launch. Now here it's saying there is some error. What it is saying: when specifying a security group, you must specify a group ID for each item. Okay, so I might have missed something. Let me create it again. ML secure SG marketplace security group for marketplace AI MLVM. Okay, I think this is fine. Let's save it. Let's try again. Okay, so here it is launching, and what we can do is we can wait for it to get provisioned, or you can view the launch in EC2 console. So I will click on the EC2 console over here. It will take me to the EC2 console. It will ask you for login credential if you are not logged in. While it is getting launched, we can also look into the usage instruction. So here are the usage instruction which we will go through as well in this video. But to summarize, the usage instruction talks about once you log in, then you can access the VM through PuTTY first. How to log in through PuTTY is mentioned in this link. If you, most of you might be aware, you know, if you have a VM, how to access it through PuTTY. The next thing is, once you connect to the VM, then you need to run this command called sudo password ubuntu to change the password for the Ubuntu user. Note that the whole VM is configured using this user ID, Ubuntu user ID. So that's very critical that you reset the password or set the password for Ubuntu user. Your access to the VM will be through this user. And then, you know, the rest of the instructions are how you are going to connect it through remote desktop and as well as using the Jupyter Hub or IPython environment. So you can follow these instructions or you can follow this video. So let's go to the EC2 environment. Now here you can see our VM is up and running. I'll click on this VM. And here you can get the public IP for the VM. So using this public IP, I will connect to that VM using PuTTY, and then we will update the password for the Ubuntu user. So we need to wait till the machine is up and running. Here it is saying the status check as initializing. Let it complete. Now in the main, I will open PuTTY. One thing you need to remember that you need to have the PuTTY configuration done for connecting to the EC2 instance. And as I mentioned in our instruction over here, there is this link. If you are new to how to connect to EC2 instances using PuTTY, I highly recommend going through this link. So this link from AWS will walk you through the steps to connect to any EC2 instance through PuTTY. And I am assuming that you are aware of that. If not, then you can go through this this link. Okay. So in my case, I have everything configured. The status check is complete. Now we will connect to the VM. Okay, so to connect, I will copy the public IP. I will go to PuTTY and I will put my IP address. Make sure that your port is 22. You selected SSH. Click on open. Click on yes. Login as Ubuntu as the username, and it will log in into our virtual machine. Now here what you need to do is you need to change the password or set the password for Ubuntu user. Why we need to do this is because for SSH you can connect it through the key, the private key you have, okay, using PuTTY. But for the remote desktop and as well as for the IPython environment, which we will discuss down the line, you need to have a password for the Ubuntu user. So for that, we'll just use sudo password Ubuntu. You need to use sudo because otherwise it will ask you for the existing password which you don't have. So here we'll enter the new password. and the password is successfully updated. So now you have it. So once you are done with this, the next step is you can either connect to the VM and use the VM through the remote desktop, which I will show you, or you can use the Jupyter or IPython environment. So if you prefer remote desktop, you can go to start, just search for remote desktop, click on this one and put the copy the IP address, and you can click on connect, accept the certificate. You can select this box so that it won't bother you next time, and click on yes. So now you can see it is connecting to the remote desktop environment. Again, it will ask you for authentication, provide the username, Ubuntu and password. Sometimes, you know, it gives you error for the first login, so you can try it again and it will get connected. So this is your remote desktop environment, and you know, a lot of things are available on the remote desktop. We'll get into details about how to use the VM in our subsequent video, but at this point you just need to know how to connect to the VM. One is you have the SSH shell through PuTTY you can connect. The other option is this one, and there is one more option which is more convenient, which is to use the IPython environment. So let's use the third option. So for that, again you need to just copy the IP address, go to the browser, use HTTP. Make sure that you are not using HTTPS, okay? Just type HTTP, give your IP address, hit enter, and then it will open the Jupyter Hub or IPython environment. In our subsequent videos, we'll get into more details about what it is, but at this point, you just need to provide the user ID and password, and it will log in into the environment. It takes some time to provision the Jupyter or IPython environment, so you need to have some patience. Here it will span a server for you, and now you will be able to access the Jupyter environment. And by default, it takes you to your home directory. And this home directory, if you click on this, it contains the sample codes, the documents and other artifacts. You can click on code, and here you have all the sample codes. In our subsequent videos, we'll go through each of these code, and you know, I'll explain you how to execute it. Okay, so this is all about how you can provision your virtual machine on AWS environment. So just to summarize, you can go to techlatest.net, go to products and select the product, and from here you can navigate to AWS marketplace, or you can go search for techlatest. It will techlatest.net, it will list all our offers. Select your offer from here, follow the instruction and get your VM provision. Then either use PuTTY to connect it, or remote desktop to connect it, or Jupyter Hub to access the notebooks. So that's all guys for this video. Thanks a lot for watching.